Welcome back. Negros will celebrate the Panaad sa Negros Occidental Festival next week. Panaad is actually a Hiligaynon word, which means promise fulfilled. Aside from being a form of thanksgiving to divine providence for abundance, locals see it as a chance, an event with a chance to draw tourists and showcase the province's rich culture.
Well, some 13 cities and 19 municipalities will participate in the week-long festivities, which include agricultural displays, sports festivals, and concerts. And to tell us more about the event, dubbed as the Festival of Festivals, the executive director of the festival, Marlin Sanogal, joins us in the studio. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Caroline. Hi. Sandy.
When did it earn that tag, Festival of Festivals, and what really makes it special among others?
Actually, Panaad sa Negros Festival started way back in 1993, and we are now on our 20th year. And it was called the Festival of Festivals because what we are showcasing are the festivals of the individual LGUs, the 32. You mentioned we have 13 cities and 19 municipalities. Mm-hmm. So all the festivals of the different LGUs are showcased in the week-long Panaad sa Negros Festival.
Mm-hmm. So it's like a one-stop shop festival. It's
celebration
in, all in one venue,
venue,
right?
Yes,
how many days?
It's 7 days in one venue in the Panaad Park and Stadium in Bacolod City. And all the LGUs have their own big houses, we call pavilions, which they showcase their products, their tourism attractions, and all other things that are they that they are promoting for the good of their cities and towns also.
Mm-hmm. But how did it exactly begin? You mentioned how far back it's been, and maybe in terms of celebrations, no, what would make it different today? Some people would be more familiar with Bacolod, just the Mascara Festival, and then of late, Panaad Stadium
sporting event. Mm-hmm. So Panaad is the convergence of all the festivals. We have Mascara Festival there. We have the Pasalamat Festival of San Carlos City, for instance, or the Pasalamat Festival of La Carlota, or the other festivals of the other cities and towns. So it's a convergence of all the festivals of the 32 LGUs in Negros Occidental. And it's not only just dancing. It's also showcasing more our products. So we have agricultural products. Like this year, our theme is celebrating Negros as the leader in organic agriculture. So the DA, Department of Agriculture, has already said that Negros Occidental is the leader in organic agriculture because we have some 10 to 12 organic villages in the province. And we are showcasing organic food, organic agriculture in the Panaad sa Negros Festival. We have daily lectures on how to grow organic food. That's what they call slow food. Slow food convivium, because we are promoting organic agriculture that is in line with the sustainable development and the protection of the environment. And so we also have a lunch buffet daily of organic food and of course Negros cuisine, and a lot more of like talent shows and of course the selling of the Negros products, because throughout the year we have trainings on entrepreneurship. So we discover new products, we package old products so that they can be viable in the market, and of course it's a venue for market matching also. We find buyers of our products.
Aside from the well-known products of Negros, what new products have you discovered so far, and what are you pushing in the coming years?
We are pushing to become under the leadership of our Governor Alfredo Marañon Jr. He has pushed for Negros to become a livestock center, or the center of the livestock industry. We have purchased sheep and cattle so that we will beef up our livestock industry. As you can see, we are so much dependent on sugar, and we're trying to diversify. So aside from organic food, organic agriculture, we also push livestock, and with that, of course, the corn industry to feed the livestock. And we are gearing towards a sufficiency in rice production this year, and we have been one of the top 10 producers of rice in the country. That is a very big leap, because we have always been importing rice from other provinces.
What triggered the spin-off? Because for the longest time, we've known Negros to be exactly
sugar.
That. Sugarlandia. In fact, a lot of the products really have to do with
sugar,
sweets, and the like, delicacies. Mm-hmm. But what spun off the change?
That was because of the 1980s crisis in the sugar industry, because we are so dependent on the export of sugar to other countries. And when the export is hitting a crisis, then all of us are really in a poverty situation. And that also gave rise to insurgency problems in the countryside. No? But a lot of that is now in the history of Negros Occidental. We have become a more or less a diversified province with a lot of other products, like aside from food, of course, we have we are also known for the furniture, for children's dresses. We also have a silk industry, the Oiska silk industry, and we produce a lot, about 80 to 85% of the country's market for silk. And of course, there are a lot more, like we develop our dairy industry, not only for the dairy supply of milk for the regular households, but most especially for our nutrition program for the malnourished children. Mm-hmm. Because that was the crisis in the 80s, we were known for the poor children of Negros, the hungry children of Negros. So we're trying to build our nutrition program with an infusion of dairies, milk supplementation, mm-hmm. and this goes with the livestock industry and also the rice productivity.
Sounds like a mission right there. But what does Negros Occidental have going for it that would make the province viable for all these other industries outside sugar?
Of course, the very big promising industry would be tourism also. We have developed our, like for instance, the provincial government runs a tourist flagship tourism program, Mambocal Resort. We have in the resort 7 waterfalls, and of course we have a lot of hot sulfur springs. So we make hot sulfur baths for this, and these are very prominent among Japanese, the Koreans, the Chinese. And there's a lot other tourism destinations all over the province, like we have sugar beaches. If Boracay has this powdery sand beach in Boracay, we also have a sugary beach. We call it sugar beach because it's coarser than Boracay sand. It's like sugar, the brown sugar that we have in Negros. The sand in the beaches in southern Negros look like that. And of course, we have a lot of nature adventure destinations, because we have marine sanctuaries. We have the Mount Canlaon Natural Park. We have so many other emerging tourism industries, especially in ecotourism, mm-hmm. in the province.
Yeah, that's interesting, because there's a growing sector out there. It's a health and wellness market.
Yes.
How does Negros intend to tap into that market?
The sulfur, hot sulfur baths are really part of the wellness program, and of course we have good hospitals also. That's why even the provincial government has developed our own run provincial hospital and district hospitals. We have 10 all over the province, and the governor has spent big amounts for the rehabilitation of the hospital, so that especially we built a new one in Sipalay City, the diving area, because we need to have hospitals for tourists also, aside from the locals. So these are programs that will really find livelihood for our people, generate employment in tourism sector. So these are tied up with the wellness industry, and the organic agriculture, the food, slow food program is also towards wellness, because as we can see, so many illnesses are now being felt because of the change in weather,
the kind of weather
that we have now, the kind of environment. So we're going back to nature. We're promoting organic agriculture, organic food, and of course the sheep industry is also, because the sheep is a kind of low cholesterol meat, and it goes with our organic movement.
Mm-hmm. And this has also in a way changed the cuisine?
Yes, in a way we are gearing towards something healthy. And we have a lot of restaurants already that are serving organic food. And we have I mentioned earlier, 10 to 12 villages, they grow organic vegetables, organic pork, organic chicken. So we're going back to the natural way of doing things, and this will really protect our health as well as also save the environment.
But it's not to say we're losing sight of sweets, of course.
Of course, there should always be sugar because that is why we are what we call life is sweeter in Negros, because of our sugar. So basically, the main backbone of the Negros economy will still be sugar. And aside from sugar, the sugar industry because you will also be able to generate biofuels. So we're going into that also. At least 2 sugar centrals are producing bioethanol. Mm-hmm. And we hope really that this will also be another industry that will bring Negros towards a greater employment for its people also.
Not to mention self-sufficiency.
Yes, when it self-sufficiency comes to in fuel.
Yeah. Yes. This being the 20th year you're marking it, maybe give us a semblance of what the festivities are like in the course of those 7 days, and maybe what would people look out for? What should they look out for?
Yes, okay. On Monday, we will be opening the festival. Of course, we will... there are festival dances. We let our LGUs compete for the best festival dance. As I mentioned, we have 32 LGUs. We have 32 dances, dance festivals, except for Mascara. Mascara is doing a presentation, but they are not joining the competition because, of course, Mascara is Mascara. It's international. Mm-hmm. So the rest of the LGUs compete for the title of the best festival in Negros for the year, because every year we do it also. And of course, we have the biggest, the new program in Panad sa Negros is the, for 3 years now, we are giving awards to our farmers, recognition for farmers, livestock raisers, fisher folks, so that they will continue to really produce more for our food sufficiency and agricultural productivity target. And this year, we will also be honoring our founders of Panad. So we will honor the governor that started it all, Governor Coscoluela, and also the rest of the governors that sustained it, like the late Governor Joseph Marañon, Governor Isidro Saico, and the current Governor Alfredo Marañon Jr. And we will also be having the indigenous peoples are also joining our festivities. So all sectors are represented in the festival. And this year we started to invite the Department of Tourism to put up their own exhibit also. The Board of Investments are coming also, the Department of Trade and Industry, they're also coming, so that we will have a one-stop shop of exhibits and information advocacy for people to know how they can avail of the services of these departments of the national government.
And entrance is free?
No, it's also free. Okay. It's also free. We are partnering with a lot of companies or corporate sponsors, so that we have every night we have concerts. We have competitions for the singing, dancing, also for sports. We have different kinds of sports. Of course, Negros also a sporting destination, especially as you mentioned, we have the Panaad Park. And of course, we have all these sports events, and including derby, because Negros will not be Negros without a bulangon, that we call it, cockfighting. That's also one of the must-see in Panaad, because some people really go to Negros to have these cockfighting events there to watch and join, actually. And so we also have a lot of other contests and a lot of other activities, including the search for the lady that will epitomize the Negrense beauty. We have Lin Aisang Negros. So out of the beauties of the 32 towns and cities, we choose one to represent Negros as the Negros queen.
It's easy to get an information overload with all that. You wouldn't know where to begin. But picking up from Stanley's staple question sometimes, maybe to end this, what would be the top few picks, perhaps, for a first-time visitor? What would you recommend?
We recommend, of course, for them to go in all the LGU's pavilion, because the pavilions are something like Enayang Pilipino to Enayang Pilipinas to the Philippines. The Panaad is for Negros. We have arranged the pavilions geographically. So if you start from the north, you will in one day you will be able to tour Negros in one day, looking at the products of every LGU, sampling their food, and also looking at their exhibits of tourism destinations, including agricultural products, including entrepreneurial products. And of course, we have guides in all the LG pavilions to guide them towards really visiting Negros in one park.
And
in
I
one
think
day.
There's reason enough to do that, because one of the biggest toasts of the province really is its people, isn't
yes,
it?
Yes, people and food.
Mm-hmm. And on that note, thank you very much.
Thank you so much for inviting
us here.
Ms. Marlene
Sanogal, Executive Director of the Panaad sa Negros Occidental. And more power to you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Up next, several Americans were killed in attacks in Afghanistan.
And Argentina vows to help flood victims get back on their feet. We'll be right back.